your presentation. And our next speaker is from Spain, and his name is Antonio La Santa. Antonio, please start.
Hi.
Hi.
Can you see my presentation?
Yeah, we have your screen.
Can you hear me? Okay.
No.
Yes. So, okay. Julia, please mute your microphone. Yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, thank you for this opportunity. I'm very happy to be here because this is a very dynamic and nice style of conference. I like this. Okay, I will start to present my work, but before I would like to thank my collaborator. The first one is Raul, our former chairman. After Raul, we have Francisco Vega Reyes, Miguel Ángel López Castaño, and Andrés Santos, Aurora, Manuel, Antonio Prado.
Antonio, I cannot see your slide. I see only a dark screen.
No.
Or is that my problem or?
No.
Yes. It's okay now.
Okay. I try.
No.
Bigger. Okay. No?
I don't know, but I think you have, others also have the same problem. I think when you go to full screen,
I try. This is another one. This one, can you see this?
It's okay now.
No, it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And this is my collaborator. this is my publication. Okay, I first will start using a definition of what is a memory effect. I think the main point is a possible definition. After I will show some sample, very interesting, I think very amazing examples. And after that, I will present my own work about two memory effects with names. Those are Kovac effect and Mpemba effect. Okay, what is a memory effect? Okay, that a definition could be memory connotes the ability to encode and access and erase signatures of past history in the state of a system. This is a definition from this very nice report that is memory formation in matter. Okay? It's a thing that you can understand easily. My first example, share memory effect in amorphous solid. Okay. This is based on this work. You have an ensemble of Leonard John particles. For example, you can try this assemble to prepare the assemble to be that this ensemble to have some properties or some memory. So you can try your system doing one cycle of training. You apply a strain to the right and strain to the left. If you do this once, you have this mean square displacement. If you do this twice, you have the green line. If you do this three times, you have the red one, and so on. So we can learn from here that we can train our system, even a very simple system, such as a Leonard-Young mixture. Okay, this is the first one. Another well-known effect is the aging effect. You can, for example, you have a glass. Glass is a collection of Leonard Young, also again a Leonard Young of particles, and you can fix a temperature. You wait with this temperature T1. You wait this time, and you obtain an aging. The name is aging effect. After you change again your temperature and your weight, and you obtain this curve rejuvenation, okay? And finally, you change again thermostat to the first one temperature, and you obtain this curve, okay, this aging. If you, once you have done this procedure, you can go back with the temperature and obtain this curve. You have trained, okay? You have include memory in your system. In a spin glass is a well-known effect if you do this in a spin glass. This is theory, okay, simulation. And this is an experiment in this well-known paper. You can hot your system, wait for a while at this point, and after hot again your system, wait for a while, and so on. Okay, this is the why the not filled points. Okay, you go in this direction. And if you go back the same procedure, but without waiting, your system follow the same trajectory. Can you see the filled dots? So I think this is very interesting. We have another kind of memory effect. The third one, we can go to living matter and apply a flux, a force in a red blood cell. And so you can see that the cell and the center of the cell, the concave place, because the cell is the concave, you can see how this is strength, a change the position, and also the length, okay? If you put out your force, the cell, back to the original form. So the red blood cell, fortunately, have memory. I think it's very... This happens when the red blood cell are go out the heart, okay? After example is the acting network. If you apply, right.
Okay. Sorry, Antonio, I have a question. So, what type of force do you apply in a red blood cell?
When the red blood cell are going out the heart, very strong pressure and strain is applied in the flux, okay, in the blood.
So you are doing a...
You have a compression, like a compression, okay?
Okay. So it's not an experiment with a single red blood cell, but with a stream of red blood cells.
Uh-huh. Okay. I'm going a bit fast because I would like to...
Okay.
This is only to explain a general perspective memory, different memory effect, okay? This is another experiment. You apply... and a strain in an acting network, so this acting network distribute in an optimal distribution in this sense. And so when you try again to apply this strain to this acting network, it is easier than the first one. You can see this a little bit, but you have this disorder, and when you apply compression, okay, you see that all the network is in the, more or less in the same direction, okay? So you are applying some preparation or some procedure where the system remember something. How do you prepare the system or so on?
Antonio, could you please make the presentation full screen? It's very difficult to read the fonts.
Because the before you can see in the okay. Now can you see?
Yes.
Okay.
You can see.
The last
Sorry,
one
can
is,
I ask?
Sorry?
Can I ask one question?
Yes, yeah, sure.
Are the results that you were showing in the previous slides the results of experiments, or are also theory or computation?
Sorry, I can hear you.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
The results that you show in the previous few slides are the results of experiments or theory and computation?
No, about the acting network are experiments.
All of them experiment. Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay. This is my last sample. This is a memory of effect in HIV virus. Okay. This is very interesting because this is also a coronavirus kind of virus. Okay. This is a very interesting paper where they studied that when antibody acts on a HIV virus, this virus remember where this antibody acts. So they have peaks in these places where the virus acts. So the virus mutes and remember where the antibody acts. So the next time that the antibody acts on this virus, it's innocuous, nothing happens. So the virus is very difficult to design a vacuum, for example.
And 5 minutes left.
Sorry?
Only 5 minutes left, Antonio. You have only 5 minutes.
Okay. So this can be modeled with a simply Hopkin model. You can define the minimum of the model, and so you have a memory in this sense, and you modify this minimum, and so you have a different structure of the RN. So this is only a fast abstract of the paper, okay? And the last one is this associative memory that you can design a puzzle, so you only can order the pieces in two or three or whatever kind of distribution. You can see here the 1, 2, or 3 minimum of the energy, the same of the entropy of the system. Okay, this is our example and not my example. Okay, so the Kovac effect. What's the Kovac effect? The Kovac effect and the Mpemba effect are effects where you do some protocol or prepare the system in some way. Okay? This is the original experiment where you have a protocol, you hold the system, maintain the temperature constant, and when at the middle of the protocol, of the heating protocol, you change the thermostat and you observe a bump. Okay? We will see this in another result. This is more or less the same. You can see those bumps, okay? Okay, my interest, granular medium. What is a granular medium? It's a prototypical sample null equilibrium system, intrinsic not equilibrium system. Why I'm interested in granular medium? Because we can compute everything in the dilute regime. We have kinetic theory, and we can compute sample coefficient, hydrodynamic equation, and we also know how to simulate the system, okay? Using molecular dynamic simulation. So we can try to study or understand some memory effect and to see if we have some elemental ingredients to understand elemental ingredients to reproduce those memory effects, okay? In the first case, the Kovac effect. So we can see our protocol. We have the system at one temperature with a thermostat. Our thermostat is a Gaussian noise, heating the particles, okay? And we can see here the red curve where the system is cooling, and we stop the cooling and change the thermostat, okay? And we have this bump in the temperature is in the figure. We have two Kovac effects in the same sense and direction of the heating or the cooling, okay? This is a work by Prados and Trissac. Why can do this? But this happens because if we compute the hydrodynamic equation, we can see that the temperature is not an autonomous equation. Depends also of this coefficient A2. What is this A2? This is the kurtosis, the non-Gaussianity of the distribution function, okay? So we can see that we can tune this kurtosis, okay? We can tune this kurtosis and obtain some kind of memory effect, okay? Because the temperature is not autonomous. That depend on this kurtosis. So we can see effectively that we have this hump. This hump depends on the difference of the two kurtosis, the initial kurtosis, A2 initial, and the final kurtosis. Okay, this is the theoretical explanation in grammar matter of this kind of memory effect. What the mean of this? But this is that the system remembers where are you coming from. Okay, we can see also in a other kind of grammar medium that we have friction between particles. So we can have this kind of Kovac effect, that is a giant Kovac effect, okay? And my last example is this, I think is the most interesting, is the Penman effect. What is the Penman effect? The Penman effect is an effect...
Antonio, sorry, please wrap up your presentation.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
You okay,
have 30 seconds time still.
Okay. Okay, no, it's okay. I can finish just here. Questions? I'm sorry, but maybe I have been very fast. Not too fast.
Okay, thank you. You finish your talk? Okay. So any question? Okay. Let's thank our speaker.